you took the fall, but you thought of me above all. Above all powers, above all kings, above all nature and all created things. All wisdom and all the ways of man, you were here before the world began. Above all kingdoms, above all thrones, above all wonders the world has ever known, above all treasures of the earth, there's no way to measure what your worth,
my Lord.
Crucified, laid behind a stone, you live to die. Took the fall, and you thought of me above.
That's what Steve sang in the morning this morning.
You were crucified, laid behind a stone. You lived to die, rejected and alone, like a rose trampled on the ground. You took the fall, but you thought of me above all, like a rose trampled on the ground. You took the fall, but you thought of me above.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to the sweet Lamb of God. We have some new members that have joined our church, and we have some certificates that state that they're a member in good standing with our church, and we're so proud to have them with us. If they could please come forward, Sister Ann Freeman, Brother Wayne Bryant, Sister Karen Bryant, Sister Maxine Jarvis, and Brother Jeff Bowman. Hallelujah. Brother Jeff's on the camera, so if he wants to wait, we can do that. Sister Ann, stand right here, please. Okay. Sister Maxine. Okay, already. Brother Jeff. Brother Wayne. Sister Karen. Praise the Lord. Turn and face everyone. Now, these are our newest members of the Fruit of Labor Worship Center. Praise the Lord. Give them a big hand. We're so glad they're here. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you very much. God bless you all.
Glory to God. Isn't God wonderful this morning? Amen. Hallelujah. Are you ready to hear the word of God? Amen. Hallelujah. I want you to stand with me this morning. You got your Bibles? Lift them high. Hallelujah. Glory to God. This is the word of God, and I believe it. It is inerrant. It has no error. It is infallible. It cannot fail. It is the inspired word of the living God to my life. It is my rule of conduct and my standard of living. By it to live, by it to move, by it to have my being, it is life to me and health to all my flesh. Praise. Now give God glory, praise, and honor as our pastor Hallelujah. Comes this morning.
Thank you, Brother Norman.
Jesus. Life is easy when you're up on the mountain. You've got peace of mind like you've never known. But then things changes. You're down in the valley. Don't lose faith, for you're never alone. For the God on the mountain is still God in the valley when things go wrong. You know that He'll make them right. Yes, He will. And the God of the good times is still God in the bad times. The God of the day is still God in the night. You talk of faith when you're up on the mountain, but talk comes so easy when life's at its best. But it's down in the valley of trials and temptations, that's when faith is really put to the test. Yes, it is. The God on the mountain is still God in the valley when things go so wrong. You know that He'll make things right. And the God of the good is still God in the bad times. The God of the day is still God in the night. You talk of faith when you're so high upon the mountain, but talk comes so easy when life's at its best. But it's down in that valley of trials and temptations, that's when faith is really put to the test. But the God on the mountain is still God in the valley when things go so wrong. You know that He'll make things right. And the God of the good times is still God in the bad times. The God of the day is still God in the night. Oh, the God of the day is still God in the night. Yes, He's still God. Aren't you glad about that? Aren't you glad He's still God when things are going wrong? He's still God when things are going great. He's still God when you're down in the valley walking all alone at midnight. God is still God. That's the great promise that we have. He said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. Amen. Aren't you glad about that? Even though it seems at times that we're going through such heartache, such great turmoil, that no one really cares, but God is still God. I'm so glad of that, aren't you? It's good to be in God's house today. Good to have Brother Norman's family with us today. God bless you. We just ask God to bless you abundantly. Good to have all of you here with us today. Pray for those that are not here this morning. Remember our last Friday night of this month, Friday night, July the 26th, special service that night, joining another church with us. The name just slipped my mind. It's Free Will Baptist Church, where my brother goes out at Waynesville. I can't even think of the name of it now, but anyway, it doesn't matter. But they'll be with us on that Friday night. Their pastor will be here. We'll be doing a joint service, ministering and praying and rejoicing in the Lord. You're going to have a wonderful time that night. So you be sure and be here, because a lot of them Free Will Baptist folks going to be here and just shouting the praises of God, and looking forward to that. Remember, we're our revival, our fall revival, beginning September the 22nd on Sunday night through Friday night, September the 27th. Mark that down on your calendar, September the 22nd through September the 27th. Amen. And I won't promise you, but I'm trying to get Sister Betty Jean Robinson to be with us a few nights that during that revival. How many members here, Sister Betty Jean, when we was on Haywood Road over there, she was with us for several nights during one of our, Brother George Wright was ministering, I believe, and she was there with us several times. But I won't promise that she'll be able to be here, but trying to get something worked out there. But anyway, God will still be here anyway. And we're going to have a wonderful, wonderful revival that week. Amen. God is good.
Pastor, may I make an announcement to you?
Yes, brother.
I thought you about done there. The Lord's opened the door for us to go to the women's prison. It's all set in place. The lady that runs it remembers me from 8 years ago. She's excited to get us in there. We have to, anybody that even thinks they might be interested even down the road a year from now needs to go to what they call orientation. It's a one-time visit.
Yes.
They tell you the rules. They give you a badge, a little membership card. And then from there on out, anytime you want to go, you can go anytime with us you want. But if you don't go to that meeting, you can't go.
Yeah.
So please pray about it. October the 8th, go with us. Let's get our badge, our sticker. And then from there, we can go as many. Well, we have the third Saturday night of every month, a two-hour slot.
Wow.
The same slot I used to have 10 years ago, brother, or 8 years.
Wonderful.
God's opened a door, and I believe he's going to do great, wonderful things there. So please, at least get your card. And then next year, you hear about all the miracles. You say, boy, I'd sure love to go. You've got your card. You can go.
Amen.
But you got to get the card. Let's go October the 8th.
Now, is that on a Saturday?
I think it's a weeknight, brother. It's 6 p.m.
Okay, it's over the night time.
Yes, sir.
Okay, good, good, good. Yes, we're going to be there.
Yes.
Think about it. Getting into a prison. And, Brother Dennis, I think you said they had a new chapel place or something like that where it's all set up. We don't have to take no or no PA system, maybe a few instruments maybe, but we get to have church.
Church.
You don't just get to go in and just, you know, you get to have church. We set up on the platform and sing and minister and have church for 2 hours in prison.
Praise God.
Amen. That's a wonderful, wonderful. God is opening so many doors for us. It's just unbelievable what God's doing with such a small group of people. I know he's doing great things in bigger areas, but this week alone, this week, Pastor in Pakistan, Pastor John, gave me the report on Friday. He was waiting for the teams. We had 460 souls saved this
Amen.
Week.
Hallelujah.
460.
Thank you, Lord.
That goes over 1,600 in 4 weeks. Over 1,600 in 4 weeks. Think about what God is doing. Watching from. I mean, I'm not lifting us up in any way as far as us, but they take our videos that we give them. They sent me pictures of the videos. I send them videos of our services. They take them and play them, and the ones that need interpretations, they interpret it for us and make altar calls. And I didn't write everything down, but 460 were saved this week. I forget how many were filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak in other tongues there in Pakistan. That makes hundreds and hundreds filled with the Holy Ghost.
Yes,
over the last 4 weeks, speaking
Thank
in
you,
other
Lord.
Tongues,
Thank you, Lord.
Delivered from demonic powers. Amen. God is doing a great thing in countries that you would never think about. Amen. And I'm so glad about that. This coming Wednesday night, Pastor John will be live with us on Skype just for about 5 or 10 minutes, talking with us and telling us about some things that are going on and how God is moving. And we're going to be sending some money. If you want to help again, I know the Baptist church is, I think, going to help. We're going to, you know, we've seen over 1,600 saved. We've sent 100 Bibles. And he never asked me, the pastor never asked me, but I told him the other day, I said, we're going to send you some more money for Bibles.
Yeah.
I mean, you get that many people saved, and if they don't have a Bible, then what do they have to stand on? And I think, you know, that it's our responsibility if we're able to put a Bible in somebody's hand. And we can do that for, what is it, $6 a Bible, I think it is? $6 a Bible, buying it there. We have a source there in Pakistan.
Yes.
We can do it much cheaper buying it there in their language that they can read it in. And it's a great thing. So we're going to be sending some more money to buy more Bibles there. So it's a wonderful thing that God is doing. Amen. I'm so excited. So excited. God, yes, my brother. Yes, brother. Thank you so much. Rocky Branch. Thank you. Rocky Branch Free Will Baptist Church. Thank you, my brother.
And you know, Pastor Willie, you know, we're always setting goals for ourselves. And you said we got almost 1,600 souls. We need to ask God how many souls it takes to fill a cloud.
Yeah.
And we probably got a cloud about full by now, but we'll shoot for another cloud.
Amen. Amen. That's it.
Yeah, yeah.
Amen. It's just humbling to me.
Yes.
What God is doing.
Thank you, Lord.
I was talking with someone the other day, and you know, some of the old preachers from old would send their videos out in different places and see thousands of people saved, and God is still doing that today. He's still doing that. He's such a great, big, wonderful God. Amen. While we sing this song this morning in the key of G, if you have an offering before, I'm gonna preach a sermon today. You may never heard one like it, and you may say that guy's crazy, and you're right. I'm crazy for the Lord. I'm crazy, and I do crazy things.
Yes, amen.
Tonight I'm gonna do an illustrated message this morning, and tonight I'm gonna do an illustrated message of Satan bite the dust. You've seen that video of Carmen. We're going to play that tonight again. We've played it several times, of Satan bite the dust. And we're going to tell the devil tonight it's time for him to bite the dust. If you've got an offering this morning as we sing this song, I want you to bring it up and put it in the offering plate, and let's worship the Lord in our giving. Well, there's power, so much power. I know there's power in the name of Jesus. Well, there's power. So much power. I know there's power in His name. Well, a man came unto Jesus and said, Lord, I want to be healed. My body's so full of sores. He said, Lord, I got to live. And then Jesus came down and touched him. His sickness went away. Just like He healed that man, He can take your pain away. I know there's power. So much power. I know there's power in the name of Jesus. Well, there's power, so much power. I know there's power in His name. Well, if you really know that the Lord has brought you through, you ought to stand up on your feet, tell the world I'm a witness too. You ought to clap your hands, tell the world you have no doubt. Through all of your troubles and trials, my Jesus brought you out. I know there's power, so much power. I know there's power in the name of Jesus. Well, there's power, so much power. I know there's power in His name. You see, a man came unto Jesus, said, Lord, I want to be healed. My body's so full of sores. He said, Lord, I got to live. Then Jesus came down and touched him. His sickness went away. Just like He healed that man, He can take your pain away. I know there's power, so much power. I know there's power in the name of Jesus. Well, there's power, Holy Ghost power. I know there's power in His name. Well, if you really know that the Lord has brought you through, well, you ought to stand up on your feet, tell the world you're a witness to. You ought to clap your hands, tell the world you have no doubt. Through all of your troubles and trials, my Jesus brought you out. I know there's power, so much power. I know there's power in the name of Jesus. Well, there's power, so much power. I know there's power in His name. You see, the man came unto Jesus. He said, Lord, I need to be healed. You see, my body's so full of sores. He said, Lord, I got to live. Then Jesus came down and touched him. His sickness went away. But just like he healed that man, he can take your pain away. I know there's power. So much power. I know there's power in the name of Jesus. Well, there's power. So much power. I know there's power in his name. Yes, I know there's power. My Lord, give him praise today, saints. I give him glory in the house because there's power in his name. Hey, my God, there's power in his name. Power. So much power. So much power that we can't even comprehend it. In the name of Jesus. Simply in the name of Jesus. At the name of Jesus, demons have to flee. At the name of Jesus, if we believe and not doubt. If we believe, and you know, that's what's wrong with America. We believe, but we doubt too. If we believe and not doubt that there's power in the name of Jesus. Power in the name of Jesus. You know, Brother Steve graduated on into heaven. That's what we're working today for. We're working today to graduate one day, whether it's in the rapture or when they lay this body down. We're working to graduate. My Jesus. You working to graduate? Are you really working to graduate and get out of this old world? To get out of all the problems and things that are around us? Hardship, suffering, and all of the things. I believe that God is in the house today. I believe that if we'll get in our hearts and our minds that we're going to climb to the top of the ladder today. We're going to see God for who he is. We're going to see him for his glory. We're going to see him through his glory. We're going to see him around his glory. We're going to see him with his glory manifesting himself in our lives if we can only believe. You see, that's as simple as that. If we can only believe. Only believe today, saints. Only believe that he is our Savior. Only believe he is our Redeemer. Only believe he is our healer. Only believe he is the one that's going to come again one day. Only believe. Simply believe. Then we can sing with Brother Steve and all the other saints that's gone on in us if we've gone on. We can say, "Will take me out to the graveyard. Put me down 6 foot under the ground. Throw shovelfuls of dirt all over me. But when I hear that trumpet sound, I'm gonna say there ain't no grave gonna hold this body down. There ain't no grave gonna hold this body down. Well, when I hear that trumpet sound, I'm gonna get up out of the ground, cause there ain't no grave gonna hold this body down. Well, now meet me, Jesus, meet me in the middle of the air. Well, if my wings should fail me, Lord, I won't need another pair, cause there ain't no grave. Hallelujah. No grave. We're gonna hold my body down. Well, I looked across the river, saw the people dressed in white. Well, I knew it was God's people. They're doing gonna hold my body down. Well, when I hear that trumpet sound, I'm gonna get up, 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 I'm gonna get up out of that ground, cause I ain't no brave. Hallelujah. No brave. We're gonna hold my body down. When I hear that trumpet sound, Gable blows it from on high, I spread my wings to fly away, gonna live him by and by. Well, there ain't no brave. Yeah. My Lord, gonna hold my body down. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You see, that's what we can sing. That's what we can say. That's what we can live by. That's what we can hope by. If we only have faith, have faith, have faith, have faith, have faith, have faith, have faith. Jesus said, have faith in God, have faith beyond, have faith of a grain of a mustard seed, have faith, he said many times, and not doubt in your heart. I want to run now, Brother Johnny. Ain't no grave. Death can't hold you. You know, death in its happening is a horrible thing. But thank God, when this old body is laid down, when they lay this old body down in the grave, they better get out of my way when that trumpet sounds. Because I ain't going to lay there. This old body is coming out of that ground. Just as soon as I hear that trumpet sound, I don't know about you, but I feel old time Pentecostal. Oh, Holy Ghost. Oh, power. Ain't no grave. My Lord. One of these days, saints, you're going to hear a sound. My Lord, am I? You're going to hear a sound. If we're alive and remain, we're going to be called up together to be with the Lord in the air. But those dead in Christ are going to rise first. I've always said, Lord, it don't matter to me which way, whichever way it is. If I'm dead in the grave, then I'm going to rise first. But if not, I'm going to be caught up together. But either way, Lord, just let me have a hang time about a half a minute and look down and tell everybody, say, I told you so. He's coming again. I told you so, you naysayers. I told you he was coming again, and you wouldn't believe me. He's coming, and he's came. He's coming again. You that are watching in Pakistan, you that are watching in Africa, you that are watching in Hong Kong, we just got our list this morning, watching in South Africa, Saudi Arabia, United Kingdom, Pakistan, Hong Kong, and several other unknown regions that don't register on their thing. They're looking at us today. I'm here to tell you, Jesus is coming soon. He's coming soon. You better be ready. Ain't no denomination going to take you there. The only thing going to take you there is the blood that Jesus shed for me way back on Calvary. It's the blood that gives me strength from day to day, and it'll never